This is the YGTV News with Georgina White.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Wednesday the 7th of December. I'm Georgina White. Local man passed away in a motorbike accident in La Linea last night. Moroccan workers in Gibraltar continue to fight for citizenship. The GSLP accused the GSD of using taxpayers' money to fund their election projects. Ana Garcia's film Gibraltar will be shown next week for charity. How does Gibraltar's Jewish community feel about election? And finally, the Rock Hotel plans for a grand refurbishment. Scott Torrance, aged 30, passed away last night after being involved in a motorbike accident in La Linea. Scott was an officer in the Royal Gibraltar Police. Circumstances of the accident are still unknown and we are awaiting more details. Despite having lived here for many decades, many members of the Moroccan community in Gibraltar will not be granted citizenship. This means that many Moroccans will not be able to vote in tomorrow's election. EU law states that if you have lived or worked in an EU country for more than 5 years, you have the right to apply for a citizenship. This, however, is not the case for Gibraltar. YGTV spoke to Redwan El Hichichu of the Moroccan Workers Association for more details.
Good afternoon. First, the problem that to talk about the citizenships in Gibraltar or to get granted to have a nationality in Gibraltar is we're talking about three periods. If, for example, we're talking about before 2000, for example, that was nearly impossible to get citizenships in Gibraltar because the criteria was very, very difficult. After 2003, the criteria is a little bit more easy, and the only thing that you have is to speak in English and you have more than 25 or 20 years in Gibraltar. Then from 2006, the Moroccan starts have the British citizen or nationality start slowly. We're talking about the 5%, 10%. Then after 2007, then we start to be moving, and a lot of us has the nationality, so naturalization. The problem is the criteria now it's more easy, but the only thing is the government starts with us from 2006 till now 2011 starts with the over 65, the over 65 Moroccan was over 65. Then the Moroccan who lives here altogether, I mean wife and husband, the couple of both of them and children, and the one who has more children, more over than 18 years. And the rest who has, for example, they don't speak English, they have children under 18 years, they still have waiting for to get naturalized. And they have a lot of application and they still wait till now. We had a meeting last week with the chief minister, and he promised us that all the application done by the Moroccan in Gibraltar, they should solve all the problem before the end of December, before the new year.
Mere days before the election, the GSLP Alliance has claimed once again that the GSD have been using government resources to promote their party. The GSLP claimed £140,000 of taxpayers' money is used to fund the 7 Days newspaper so that it can print GSD propaganda. They also state that the present governing party has used the publication EnviroWatch to promote themselves. The leaflet includes a personal message from retiring Minister Ernest Brito. The GSLP claims that the message is clearly an electioneering message from the GST, funded by the taxpayer. The statement also notes that if the GSLP are elected into government, they will never use the taxpayers' resources for partisan ends. Local filmmaker Ana Garcia is screening her film Gibraltar for 2 days at the Leisure Centre Cinema. The documentary-style movie follows the people of Gibraltar's struggle for their homeland. The feature film will be shown on Monday evening at 6:30 p.m. and on Tuesday at noon. Tickets are priced at £5 and can be purchased at the door. All proceeds will go to Cancer Research UK, the Gibraltar branch. YGTV caught up with Ana Garcia for more information on the film.
Ana, thank you very much for taking the time to meet with us today. You're doing some screenings of your new film beginning of next week. Can you tell us a little bit about the film?
It's a film about Gibraltar, the people of Gibraltar, and our struggle for our homeland, essentially. It starts in the 1960s with the talks at the United Nations, and it goes through to the closure of the border, the life during closed frontier years, opening of the border, and then the problems that we had with Tony Blair and Peter Hain, and how Peter Ganawana stood up for Gibraltar and 2002 referendum and how we won. It kind of shows the toughest years that Gibraltar had and how we joined as a community and fought back.
Your inspiration, obviously, other than being from Gibraltar, but why do the film?
Well, it's an amazing story. So as a filmmaker, it's a bit of a gift because it's such a great story that hadn't been done before. And also as a Gibraltarian, every Gibraltarian feels very passionately about Gibraltar, and you kind of want to do everything that you can do, and I'm a filmmaker, so this is what I could do. And also my grandfather was Peter Isola, and he played a huge role in the United Nations talks with Sir Joshua Hassan, so he was obviously a massive inspiration to me as well.
Fantastic. The screening next week is to raise money for charity as well?
Yes, where all proceeds for the screening are going to Cancer Research UK, the Gibraltar branch of Cancer Research. I felt that the film is very much, it's for the Gibraltarians, it's about the Gibraltarians. I kind of wanted it to give back to the Gibraltarians as well, hence the Cancer Research charity.
Fantastic. Well, good luck with everything. Any new projects in the horizons anytime soon?
Yeah. Well, I've just done a series about airplane crashes for the Discovery Channel. Not as inspirational as Gibraltar. And I'm adapting a novel for the big screen at the moment, so watch this space.
Fantastic. We look forward to it. Thank you very much for your time.
As Gibraltar has a particularly multicultural society, election campaigns can pull in a large number of wish lists from different communities. As polling day is tomorrow, YGTV spoke to Mommy Levy about the Jewish community's requests for the new government.
The Jewish community, the only thing they need is a big hall so we can have our functions. At the moment, we use a hall which we have in the Hebrew school, and it's too small. And they've asked each party, that if whoever gets in, to if they can provide us with a hall so we can have our functions. But I must say, the Jewish community, to be fair, is very grateful to the GSD for having added an extra floor to the Hebrew school in Baumhaus Lane. And incidentally, it was inaugurated on the 113th anniversary of the school, because the Hebrew school has always been, in the morning, circular subjects, and in the afternoon, religious subjects. And a lot of money was spent there for the benefit of the school. But the money, although it's a Hebrew school, we have boys from all and girls from all religions. But for that, we're very grateful. But otherwise, I don't thank God we have everything we require.
And finally, Gibraltar's On Rock Hotel will be undergoing a refurbishment next March. The hotel is often commended by tourists for being one of the best in Gibraltar. It has been stated that the project will be completed in 2014 and will include upgrading of each room and the hotel's restaurant. The refit will also include fitting a new gym and spa. John Perez, chairman of Bland Group International, has announced, "Much of the Rock Hotel's progress depends on the success of the new airport terminal, which demonstrates Gibraltar's fit for purpose." That's the YGTV News. I'm back tomorrow evening. See you then.